So today's topic is it appearing now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So today's topics, we are going to discuss about the riveted joints for structural use, otherwise riveted joints for uniform strength. Okay. So both are same meaning, Babu. Structural use, otherwise riveted joints of uniform strength. Both are same, and the title name is Lozenzo joint. Lozenz joint. Okay. So the riveted joint is we are calling as Lozenzo joint. It is used for the roof construction, bridge constructions, and whatever the structural wherever we want to construct, there we can find that this use. Okay. So before starting this design procedure, the terminology here, this is the application of load in terms of kilonewtons or newtons. Don't consider this P as a pitch. This is the application of load. And small b is the width of the plate. And small t is the thickness of the plate. And the thickness of the butt strap is the T1. Okay, so these are all the, and small d is the diameter of the rivet. And one more thing here, the Lozenzo joint is arranging in a manner. See here, the shape is appearing here on the screen. How it is arranging? The number of rivets are going to increases from the outermost row to the innermost row. This is the outermost row, first one, and this is the innermost row. So if you observe from the outermost row to the innermost row, the number of rivets are increasing on the first plate. This is the first plate. On the second plate, if you see from the outermost row, this is the outermost row, move to innermost row, this is the third one, innermost row, the number of rivets are increasing. So how the shape is arranged here? The shape is in a manner diamond. Okay, so the reason its alternate name is given as diamond riveting. Okay, now coming to the design procedure, first one, diameter of the rivet. Diameter of the rivet, its relation is studied in the previous, D is equal to 6 root T in mm, when the thickness of the plate, if you got less than 8 mm. You studied in the design of boiler joints, this one, okay? Same relation is going to use here, D is equal to 6 root T mm, when the thickness of the plate is less than 8 mm. If our calculated thickness value is exceeding the 8 mm, then what we have to do? We have to equate the shear strength to crushing strength of the plate. This also we studied in the design of boiler joints. Same thing, principle we need to adapt here. Okay. Now the second one, number of rivets. Number of rivets, it is denoted by small n. This one we need to calculate. For number of rivets, this relation you need to remember, number of rivets equal tearing strength of the plate by least of shearing strength of the plate or rivet, comma, crushing strength of the PC. Crushing strength of the plate or rivet, least of PS or PC. Okay. Now, what is PT? So PT is here, tearing strength of the plate. It means if we apply the load here on the plate, there may be chance failure of the plate because of number of holes we are making here. So see here, I'm making the figure here. after failure. I'm drawing the figure here. Just one side of the plate I'm drawing. Now what I told, this is the width of the plate B and this is the thickness of the plate small t and this is the diameter of the rivet. Okay. These hashed lines are indicating the failure area. Okay. Now we are calculating the first one, PT, tearing strength of the plate. So tearing strength of the plate is nothing but, so because the plate is subject to tensile force, the plate is subjecting to the tensile force. So that reason the respective stress is generating here. Tensile stress here on the plate. So that reason I am writing the tensile stress equation PT by tensile failure area. So from this equation, what we can write tensile strength of the plate PT equal tensile stress into area under failure tension. So what is AT here? The AT we need to take this one. Okay, so what is 88 area of the failure under tension? This area is this thickness as a T. Now if you subtract B minus D, it means this is small r and this is small r. B minus D B minus if we subtract the from whole B to this D if we subtract then we'll get the this length and what is the width of the this rectangle that is T B minus D into T now write it here total equation sigma T into B minus D into T. Okay, ma. So this is the tearing strength of the plate due to tensile application of load. Okay. So first thing we calculated this one. Now what is the second thing in this equation? So we require the PS to calculate the number of rivet. Three parameters we required. First one PT we required. Just now we calculated. Second thing PS we required that we are calculating now. So what is PS here? PS is nothing but shear strength of the rivet. So shear strength of the rivet is, see the figure here on the screen from the front view. This is the front view and this is the top view. So from the front view, see two plates are joining in the manner bar joint and two cover plates we are adding here from the top side one and from the bottom side one. It means this is a butt joint with two straps. Okay, so that reason the shear of the rivet is going to takes place in a double manner. It means I'm drawing this figure here. Now, one failure I am drawing here. This is one failure area. We can find another failure area from the bottom side. We can find the one of the failure area from this bottom. Why I am drawing the circle? Because the rivet is in the shape of circles. This is one failure area. So this one I have shown here. So see here, initially the load we are applying on the plates in a tensile manner, but the load is distributed on the rivet in tangential manner. So that is because this is a butt strap, so one rivet of the plate is going to remains in this top strap, one rivet is going to remains in the bottom strap, and middle portion is going to come outside in this manner. Okay, so because the failure is happening in the shear, the respective stress is going to generate shear stress, that is shear load by shear failure area. So this equation may be written as shear resistance of the rivet PS equal shear stress of the permissible rivet of the plate into shear failure area. So what is AS here? The AS we have to consider this one. Okay. So this failure area combines one, this failure area and this failure area combines one. Total two failures we are able to see here. Now what is the area here? Because it is appearing in a circular manner, pi by 4 into d square, d is the diameter of the rivet. And here two failure area we are observing, so that reason I am multiplying with the two. Like this, if n number of rivets are there, that n we have to write here. Okay, now this equation we are using for the calculating number of rivets, don't consider this one and just write the basic equation sigma s t equal pi by 4 into d square into 2. This 2 I written because the two failure areas are generating here. Now this equation may be written as pi by 4 into d square into 1.75. Instead of writing 2, 1.75, this one is as per IBR, Indian Boiler Regulation. Whenever we are facing the two failure area on the rivet, we need to write 1.75. This is the shear strength of the plate or rivet. Second thing we calculated. See here, to calculate number of rivets, first we calculated the PT value, tearing strength of the plate. Second one, PC, shear strength of the rivet. Now third thing is PC we need to calculate. PC is the crushing strength of the rivet or plate. This one we need to calculate. So what is the crushing strength here? So if the plate is subjected to crushing or rivet is subjected to crushing, I'm showing the dotted line here. This area is going to subject to crush here.
Thickness T we have to take, no, sir.
Wait. This is a crushed area. So this type of failure you can find on the rivet surface also. So the respective stress is, we are taking the failure in crushing stress. So that reason, crushing stress equal crushing resistance of the rivet or plate by crushing area. So with this equation, the equation may be written as Pc equals sigma c into Ac. So what is Ac here? The Ac is along the diameter, we can find the crushing and with the thickness T. What is this thickness? That is the T. So the equation may be written as Pc equal sigma c into D into T. So after calculating the PS, PT, PC, so as per the equation, to calculate number of rivets, first we need to write the here PT, then select the least value between the PS and PC. Shear strength of the rivet, PC is nothing but crushing strength of the plate or rivet. So between these two, whichever gives the minimum value, that we have to consider here. Then we'll going to decide the how many number of rivets we are using for this joint. Okay. So third point. Third point, after getting the number of rivets, the number of rows and number of rivets in each row is going to decide it. So based on the our number of rows, suppose if you got the number of rivets as a 10, so how many number of rows you want to maintain on each plate? So this is a two plates, suppose. So here 10, here 10 rivets. If you got the answer as a number of 10, the number of rivets as a 10, then how many rows you want to maintain? Suppose we want to maintain 3 rows. This is the first row, this is the second row, this is the third row. So in each row, after deciding, suppose we want to maintain the 3 rows, in each row how many rivets we have to maintain? So if you put the here 4 rivets, then here if you put the 4 rivets, for example, I'm explaining. So 8 rivets are over here and rest of the rivets are going to place here. Here also same manner. So finally, how it look like? It look like the appearance is in the shape of diamond, because the title name is diamond riveting here. Okay. So based on the number of rivets, number of rows and number of rivets in each row is going to decided based on this value. So first see the how many rows, number of rivets are there. After that, decide these values, how many number of rows and in each row, how many rivets we have to maintain. That is going to depend this value. And the fourth one, thickness of the butt strap. So thickness of the butt strap is denoted by T1. Okay. Now its value is 1.25 into T, where T is the thickness of the plate. This value for the when single strap is used. So this T1 value may be changes 0.75 into T. It is ఇక్కడ నేను కరెక్ట్ ఉంది సో ద T1 వాల్యూ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు చేంజ్ వెన్ డబుల్ స్ట్రాప్ ఈజ్ యూజ్ Okay, remember these two values. When the single strap is given, read the question properly. So for that reason, I'm telling. First, read the question properly, whether the question is given single strap or double strap. If the question is given single strap, then we have to select this T1 value, 1.25 into T. If the question is given double strap, question itself mentioned, so double strap, then T1 value, we have to select this one. The next design is efficiency of the joint. Fifth point is efficiency of the joint. To calculate efficiency of the joint, efficiency of the joint, this is the first plate, this is the second plate, this is the axis of the row of rivet. Instead of drawing the row rivets, I'm drawing the axis. Now see here, efficiency of the joint equation is efficiency equal least of PT1 comma PT2 comma PT3 comma PS or PC by strength of the solid plate P. Okay, so PT1 is nothing but strength of the tearing strength of the plate at 1-1 section. This is the 1-1 section. PT2 means tearing strength of the plate at 2-2 section. PT3 means tearing strength of the plate at 3-3 section. This is for the first plate. In same manner, for the second plate, 3-3, 2-2, 1-1. Okay. So if you calculate for one side, so this principle is applied for the second plate also. Okay. Now the strength of the solid plate is, this is the basic equation. If we not provide the holes, any holes here, then strength of the solid plate is B into T into sigma T. It means, consider this is a solid plate. I'm applying the load here, tensile load PT. So the plate is going to fail under tension. So after failure, the cross section will appear in this manner because it is a rectangular plate. The failure area, this is the one. Now this is the width of the plate B and this is the thickness T. So this is failure, is this this joint is going to fail under the tensile load. So that reason, tensile stress equal tensile load by tensile failure. So the equation may be written as PT equal sigma T into AT. So what is AT here? B into T. So that is Pt equal sigma T into B into T. This is nothing but strength of the solid plate when there is no holes on the plate. Okay, Babu. Now, what is Pt1? Pt1 is nothing but tearing strength of the plate at 1-1 section that I am calculating now. Tearing strength of the plate at 1-1 section. So at 1-1 section, see here, Babu. In the diagram, if you see, at 1-1 section, how many number of rivets appearing? Design procedure. So at 1-1 section, single rivet is appearing. When it is subjected to load, the plate is going to fail. Okay, so after fail, how it is appears, just now I drawn in the previous slide. So in this manner, the failure area is going to appear. So here I drawn the two failure rivets. So instead of two, consider up to here, because at the first stage only single rivet is appear. Okay, this type of failure is going to we can find. So because it is failure is happening under tension, so tensile stress equal tensile by tensile failure area. Now we are calculating for the first section 1-1. So that reason I am writing that 1-1-1. So this is Pt1 equal sigma T1 AT1. So sigma T1 is nothing but tensile stress at first 1-1 section. And AT1 is nothing but failure area at the 1-1 section. So what is failure area here? Sorry, not B. Width of the plate minus D into T. So PT1 equal B minus D into T into sigma T1. This equation at 1-1 section. Now what is PT2? Tearing strength of the plate at 2-2 section. At 2-2 section, how many rivets we are able to see? We can see the two rivets. Okay, so for this, what type of stress is basically here? Tensile stress, that is PT by AT. So this is the second section. This is the one. Okay. Now this equation may be changes as PT2 equals sigma T2 into AT2. So this sigma T2, sigma T1, same value. This T, sigma T is going to not change. For understanding purpose, I'm giving the 2-2-2 numbering. Okay. Now AT2. Okay, wait. AT2. What is AT2 here? P minus B minus 2D into T. Sigma T2 into B minus 2D into T. PT2. So this particular, this equations apply when the tearing of the plate at section 2-2. But what happening here when the plate is coming outside, here at the 2-2 section tearing is taking place, but here share of the rivet is going to take place, because in front of the second row there is a one rivet is, okay, there may be chance of this, there may be shear failure of the rivet, okay, so that reason I'm adding the shear failure of the rivet. Rivet before 2-2. Okay, Babu. So this is the PT2. Remember, if you know the design procedure, no need to practice the problems, numerical solution. Okay. Now, what is PT3? Anybody can guess? PT3 means sigma T3 B minus 3D into T plus shear failure of rivet. Rivet before 3-3. So how many shear failure we can find before 3-3 section? How many shear failure areas before 3-3 section? We can find the three failure area. Here 1, 2, 3. Total three failure area we can find before the 3 section. If another 4-4 is there, suppose this is considered, this is as a 4-4 section, 4-4 row. So PT4 is sigma T4 B minus 4D into T plus shear failure area of the rivet before 4-4. So before 4-4, how many rivets are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It means 6 shear failure area of rivet we can find, isn't it, Bob? Here 3 rows are there in the figure. So that reason I written here the equation efficiency of the joint is PT1, PT2, PT3. If another row is increased, then we can write as PT4. If another row is inserted, then PT5. As increasing the number of rows, that 5, 6, 7 is going to increase. Now what is PS? Shear strength of the rivet. So that we calculated here in previous case. This is the one. And what is PC? PC is the, this is the one we calculated here. And what is the strength of the solid plate? Strength of the solid plate, just now we calculated here. After obtaining the all values, substitute here, then we will get the efficiency of the joint. Okay, this is the fifth point. Now, the sixth point is, permissible tensile strength for the plate, solid plate. These values we need to remember. Permissible tensile strength for the plate, 140 megapascal. Permissible shear stress value for the rivet, 105 megapascal. Permissible crushing stress for rivet or plate, 224 megapascal for single cover or single strap, and 280 megapascal for double cover. Okay, so these values at any cost you need to remember, Babu. These are all the permissible limits. Now the seventh point is pitch of the rivet we need to calculate. So pitch of, to calculate the pitch of the rivet, we practice in the earlier in design of boiler joints to calculate the pitch of derivative PT equal PC. Tearing strength of the plate equal crushing strength of the rivet or plate. If we equate these two, we can find the pitch of the rivet, or else we have another relation. Pitch of the rivet is equal what is that relation? Pitch of the rivet is 3D plus 5 mm. This another relation we have. Otherwise, we have another relation, that is this table. Based on the thickness, based on the diameter of the rivet, hole diameter of the rivet. So this is the one, pitch of the rivet P is equal to 3.5 mm. So this is the value. So this table is used to select the proper pitch value. And this table is used for the marginal pitch values. Margin means from the edge of the plate to rivet center. Okay, Babu. Now the next point is, seventh is over, eighth point. Just now we I said margin. So margin, another relation we have, margin equal 1.5 into D. And distance between the row of rivets. Between row of rivet. This value is, remember this value also, 2.5D to 3D. This empirical relation, whatever I'm writing direct equations, any cost you have to remember these relations. Okay. So this is the 9 points of the design procedure for the diamond riveting or lozenge joint or structural joint uniform strength. This topic having the four alternate names. Don't get confused, sir. Diamond riveting is given in the question. We forget what is diamond riveting. Okay. Specifically, this topic is having the four different names. One is a structural joint, uniform strength, lozenge joint, diamond riveting. Okay, Babu. Now we will go to one problem. Two lengths of the mild steel tie rods having the width 200 mm. B value is given 200 mm. Thickness of the rod is given 12.5 mm. Are to be connected by means of butt joint shear. Butt joint with double cover plates. What I said, read the question properly to select the strap value, T1 value. Here the question is given double cover plate. Design the joint if the permissible stresses. Okay, no need to remember here in this question because values is given in the question. 80 megapascal, 65 megapascal, 160 meg crushing, make a sketch and joint. So two length of the mild steel tie rod. So based on this one, we have to conclude this question is comes under the diamond riveting. Okay. Now for this, after completion of the entire answer, we need to construct the diagram in this manner. After completion of the entire answer, no sir, into chudale 14 members. 32. Now, as per design procedure, what is the first point? Tell me anyone. As per design procedure, what is the first point? I think nobody listening in the class.
D value. We have to find now, sir.
Diameter of the ribbon.
Yeah, sir. Exactly.
First point, diameter of the ribbon.
Six root t.
D is equal to 6 root t. So here, thickness value is given in the question, 12.5. So directly substitute here, D is equal to 6 in square root of 12.5. Tell me the D value. So, sorry, this is the diameter of rivet hole, not rivet. Diameter of the rivet hole. What is the answer? 6 root of
12.5.
21.2 mm. 21.2 mm. So, if you go through the table, here in this table, diameter of the rivet hole we calculated 21.2 mm. So where is 21.2? So here diameter of the rivet hole 21.5, it means nearly equal to this one. Our calculated value is 21.2. okay, so for this diameter of rivet hole, what is the diameter of rivet? The diameter of the rivet is 20. This value we need to consider. So now diameter of the rivet is 20 mm. Okay, now the number of rows, number of rivets, what is the equation? PT by least of PS comma PC. So first PT we need to calculate. So to PT is tearing strength of the plate, that is B minus D into T into sigma T. Sigma T value is given in the question, T value is given in the question, B value also given, D value just we calculated just now, 20 mm. Substitute the all values here. D is the diameter of the rivet hole, not diameter of rivet, this one. Substitute the all values, tell me the PET value. 200 minus 21.2 into 12.5 into sigma T. Sigma T value is given, tensile stress 80 MPa. Now what is PT in terms of newtons? Make it fast, Bob. What is PT? Make it fast. We have only 10 minutes. So with this topic, in design of riveting system, only one topic is left out, design of riveting for the eccentric load condition. If we complete one the topic, we'll complete the second topic in the fourth unit. So 17800, very good. Okay, very good. Now what is PS? Shear strength of the rivet. Okay, so for this, here question is given double cover. double step. Okay, so double step means definitely the failure area for the riveted joint is two failure areas. So for that, PSM writing sigma s into pi by 4 into d square into 1.75. Why I'm writing 1.75? Because this value as per IBR, actually we have to write in place of 1.75, we have to write 2. But as per Indian boiler regulation, we need to take the, instead of 2, we have to take the 1.75. Okay. So PS equal sigma S value is given in the question as 65 megapascal, 65 into pi by 4 into d square, 21.2 whole square into 1.75. Now tell me what is PS in terms of newtons. Make it fast, Babu. Make it fast. Four zero one fifty two. Point five. Okay. 0.5 newtons. Now, what is PC, crushing strength of the riveter plate? This is equation is d into sigma t c. So d value 21.2, thickness 12.5, sigma c value is given 160 megapascal. Now tell me PC value in terms of newtons. Make it fast. Four to four hundred. Now, PT calculated, PS calculated, PC calculated. Write the these values here. PT is 178,800. What is the equation here? List of PS PC. So list of PS PC. Which one is the least between the PS and PC? Which one is the least value? PC is a 42,400. This one 40,152. It means PS is the least value. So writing the PS value here, 40,152.5. Now tell me the how many number of rivets are getting? 178,800 by 0.44. See once more. Not like that. Make it correct. I think you should. Wait, I'm doing here. 178,800 by 40,152.5. 4.4, Babu. Why you are getting 0.44? I don't know. 4.45, the answer. 4.45. It means nearly I'm taking 5 rivets. Because this is a infraction we are getting. So that reason blindly we are taking number of rivets as a 5. Okay, so see the figure also here. See the figure here. Okay, figure here. on each plate. This is the first plate. This is the second plate. So number of rivets we calculated. Now the what is the third point? Number of rows and number of rivets in each row is decided after calculating the number of rivets. So it means this is totally depends on you, not on me, not on the examiner. Okay. So it arrange in a arrange the rivets in a finally the shape of the rivet arrangement should be appear in a diamond shape. So five rivets we got. So five rivets means if I draw the three rows, in first two rows, if I place the two rivets, total four rivets over here, and finally one rivet is going to be kept at the first row. Okay, wow. So like that we can arrange. Now, why sir, we are arranging in this only? It means your wish, Babu. You can arrange in your own way, but the shape should be appears in a diamond manner, diamond shape. So here I am drawing the diamond shape here because the title itself diamond zone, diamond riveting. If I draw the outline, it is appearing in a diamond shape. Okay. So here decided after number of rivet calculating, three rows are decided, and each row, first two row, two rivets are placed, and in the last row, one rivet is placed. Over. Now, what is the fourth point? Thickness of the butt strap. Thickness of the butt strap, T1. So for T1, we have two relations. What are those? See here. For thickness of the butt strap, we have two relations: 1.25 into T, 0.75 into T. So which one we have to take between these two in this question? Anybody? Please give me the answer. Between these two values, T1 values, which one I have to select, 1.25T or 0.75T? Nobody listening the class, I think. Why 0.75 into T, Babu? 13? Some rule number 6 given 1.25. Why 1.25? Why 0.75? Give the explanation. Give me the explanation why we are taking the